When we eat fish and seafood products, we're also purchasing the health benefits of seafood. And those health benefits are actually delivered by the food web, not by the fish themselves. So we might be buying in the market something that looks like fish, but it might have been fed with soybean. And I think there are fundamental risks in that pathway.
Hang on a minute. That's very different from what I heard at the salmon feed factory. Professor Duarte is saying that the health benefits of seafood come directly from what the fish eat in the wild. So pellets made with land-based proteins may not deliver us the same nutrition.
So I don't think there's a future anywhere in farming salmon and tuna. And we have to realise that that industry is only 30 years old, whereas we have been farming and growing food on land for 10,000 years. We are now just in our generation learning how to control the food production from the ocean. So the learning curve...
So the World Authority on Aquaculture thinks there's no future in farming salmon or tuna. And the prawn farming I saw in Thailand was devastating the environment to feed the prawns. So that's clearly not the future either. So is there any aquaculture that is not having an impact on the environment? Professor Duarte has suggested a trip to North Queensland to visit an Australian prawn farm.
Having seen those prawn farms in Thailand, I've got to say, it's pretty shocking. There's got to be a better way. So I've come to far North Queensland, where they've got what they reckon are prawn farms that are world's best practice.
Close to the ocean, but totally separate from it, Pacific Reef Fisheries has 70 ponds, each holding 500,000 prawns. That's a lot of prawns to feed and a lot of prawn poo to clean up. Tackling these problems is this group of scientists and entrepreneurs, and they reckon they have some answers.
We don't believe in the long term that it's sustainable to go and catch wild animals and, grind them up and feed them to farmed animals.
Over the last 10 years, they've developed a new additive for prawn feed called Novac, replacing the need for wild fish in the feed. Novac is made with what prawns naturally eat in the wild, tiny marine microbes, which Nigel Preston and his team at the CSIRO have learned to cultivate in seawater.
How are you going?
No?
No, you don't want me to look at it? OK. No worries.